Praise the Lord, I am Pastor Sherwood Hamilton of the House of Prayer in Darlington, South Carolina, located at 1349 Rogers Road. I'd like to welcome you to all of our services held on Friday nights at 8 p.m. and on Saturdays at 10:30 a.m. as well as 3 p.m. You are welcome to come join us, hear the word of the Lord, and to rejoice before our great and mighty God. We are people that believe and serve the Lord according to the scriptures. Amen. Because Mark chapter 9, verse 7 tells us,
"And there was a cloud that overshadowed them."
Yes.
"And a voice came out of the cloud, saying,"
we heard this voice say,
"This is my beloved son, hear him."
This is my beloved son, hear him. So all the words that we read and read from Christ and everything that comes out of the mouth of the Father, we are people striving to do just those things. John 12 and 49 tells us exactly where Christ got his words from.
"For I have not spoken of myself."
Listen to what he says.
"But the Father which sent me," he gave me a commandment, "what I should say and what I should speak."
The Father told him exactly what to say. And one of those profound things that the Father told Christ to say is found in Matthew 4 and verse 4.
"But he answered and said,"
"it is written." "It is written."
"Man should not live by bread alone."
"Man should not live by bread alone."
"But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God."
"But by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God." If you take anyone else's word above what God has spoken, then Luke 6 and 46 applies to you.
"And why call ye me Lord, Lord?"
Why bother calling Christ your Lord?
"And do not the things which I say."
If you're not willing to do the things that he says. We are in the last days and we are striving to continue in the faith.
Amen.
That was once delivered unto the saints.
Amen.
And in doing so, we study the scriptures to make sure that we're doing the things that God has commanded. And as we begin to study the scriptures, we begin to find out that some of the things that have been passed down to us through our forefathers were lies.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we do not dismiss what God is showing us in the scriptures. Amen. Praise God. And one of the things that God has revealed unto us, amen, praise God, and not just to us alone. Amen. First of all, I want you to understand that when Christ came preaching, let's go to Mark right quick. When Christ came preaching, he came with a particular message.
Amen.
And that message is still must be preached even today. Mark 1:14. Amen, praise God. Through this message, amen, praise God, you will find out certain things that your forefathers may or may not have mentioned unto you. Mark 1 and 14 tells us what Jesus came doing.
"Now after that John was put in prison, Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God, and saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel."
It's through this gospel, if you believe it as it is written, if God opened your eyes to it, you're going to find out that there are some things that you have been taught over your life that may or may not have been according to what God has declared.
Amen.
Want to read 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. "These things are hid from most of the people, as Christ said," amen, praise God, "that this is a mystery," amen, praise God, "but to a certain group," amen, "it has been given unto them to know the mysteries of the kingdom of God." Amen, praise God. And when you hear me say us, I'm referring to those who have the Spirit of God. So if you have the Spirit of God, then what we say on this broadcast, amen, praise God, will resonate with your heart, amen, and you will see that it is, in fact, what God is saying. Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9.
"But as it is written,"
it is written,
I have not seen, nor ear heard,
neither have entered to the heart of man,
the things which God hath prepared for them that love him."
This is something that everybody cannot get because it have not been revealed, amen, praise God, to man.
Amen.
Natural man, as the scripture lets us know, cannot or will not perceive or will not even accept and many of the things that are of God. But
God has revealed them to us by His Spirit.
There is a but. And God has revealed the things that He has not revealed unto man. He
by
has
His
revealed
Spirit.
Them to who?
To us.
To us.
By His Spirit.
Us. The ones that have the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
One of those things that God has revealed unto us. You quite have heard, you may have heard the child ask you, Mom, Dad, what do God looks like?
Amen.
What do God look like?
Amen.
You know, people have made movies about heaven and people have written books about heaven and folk have come back from the dead and say they have gone into heaven and they have seen God.
Amen.
And they give their particular description of Him. Mm-hmm. Amen. Praise God. But let's look at the scriptures and see what God looks like. First off, let's examine these claims of people going to heaven and seeing God. Genesis 17, verse 1. Again, through the gospel, you will find out marvelous things.
Amen.
And some of those things that you find out, amen, are going to contradict what you've been hearing all your life or what is most popular in the Bible bookstore. Genesis 17 and verse 1.
And when Abram was 90 years old.
When Abram was 90 years old.
And nine. The Lord appeared to Abram and said unto him, I am the Almighty God.
So here's a scripture that one might pull out and say, well, look, God has revealed himself to Abram. Exodus chapter 24, verse 10. Amen. I am aware of many passages in the scriptures that tells us that God showed himself, amen, praise God, to certain patriarchs in the Bible. Exodus chapter 24, verse 10.
And they saw the God of Israel.
The ancient Israelites, and amen, it is written that they saw.
And they saw the God of Israel.
The God of Israel.
And there was under his feet, as it were, a painted work of a sapphire stone.
Yes.
And as it were, the body of heaven in his clearness.
So here, go ahead, bro.
And upon the nobles of the children of Israel, he laid not his hand. Also, they saw God, and they did eat and drink.
The noble, the meaning the elders, amen, of the ancient Israelites, saw up under the feet of God.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Amen. This glorified image. Go read the Habakkuk, chapter 3, verse 3. Amen. Praise God. Believe me, listener. I don't dismiss anything that's found in the Word of God. Amen. Praise God. As the scripture declares again in Matthew 4 and 4, man must live by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Amen. Habakkuk 3, verse 3.
God came from Teman.
God came from Teman.
And the Holy One from Mount Paran. Selah.
The Holy One came. Listen to the
His
word.
His glory now. Covered the heavens.
His glory covered the heavens.
And the earth was full of His praise.
The earth was filled with His praise.
And His brightness was as the light.
His brightness was as the light.
He had horns coming out of His hand.
Horns coming out of His hand.
And there was the hiding of His power.
Wow. My God. God revealing Himself. Amen. Praise God. This is the glory of God. Being revealed, amen, praise God, to His people. Amen, praise God. We hear hands and we hear feet. Amen, praise God. But did anybody see God's face?
Amen.
Amen. Go to Exodus. Amen, praise God, chapter 33 and verse 20. Amen, praise God. For everyone that have supposedly have ascended into heaven, amen, praise God, if but for a moment, amen, and was brought before God, and they give their testimonies on how they've seen the Son and how they've seen God, and others have said they've seen the Holy Ghost, amen, praise God, creating this Trinity theology, amen, praise God. But God told Moses something, amen, and again, I'd rather believe what God said before I believe what any other man says. Exodus chapter 33 and verse 20.
And he said, thou cannot see my face.
Thou cannot see my face.
For thou shalt no man see me.
No man shall see me.
And live.
And live. So every book that someone is selling in the Bible bookstore that claim that they have died and went to heaven and saw God. Keep your money. Don't waste it. Because the book is based upon a lie.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God. 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 16. Amen. Praise God. What they saw, amen, was the glory of God, amen, as God revealed it to them. They did not see God. 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 16.
Who only hath immortality.
He only has immortality.
Dwelling in the light which no man can approach.
Dwelling in a light which no man, hold right there, bro. So they have died and went to heaven. And they're saying they were brought before the throne and they saw Jesus. They say they saw God. And some say they saw the Holy Ghost and the angels and all family members. But the scripture says that God dwells within a light that no man can approach. 1 John verse 4, verse 12. We're just going to first acknowledge that these people have been lying. That no man have seen God's face. Not a single living soul. 1 John chapter 4, verse 12. If you believe God, believe what God has left on record for you.
No man.
No man.
Have seen God at any time.
No man have seen God at any time. That cuts out the lie that Enoch and Elijah have went to heaven and now they're in the presence of God. Put that to the side.
Amen.
Here we're reading in the book of John.
No man.
Amen. Hundreds of years later.
No
amen.
Man.
Amen. Praise God. And he speaks by the way of the Holy Ghost. And he declares that no man
have seen
God
at any time.
At any time. So what do God look like if no man have seen him at any time? Amen. Praise God. Go with me to Colossians 1 and verse 15. Why can't, amen, praise God, if these people have gone up there, why is it that they haven't seen God? Colossians 1 and verse 15.
Who is the image of the invisible God?
Christ is the image of the invisible God. Hold right there, brother. Now, many have the picture on their wall of this man with this pale face and long brown hair.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. That is not the image of God.
Amen.
That is the image of a man.
Go ahead.
Amen. Praise God. So take that image and put it out of your home.
Go ahead.
Amen. If it's in your Bible, amen. Praise God. Go ahead and rip that page out because that is not the image of God.
Amen.
God does not look
like
Uncle Joe and Uncle Billy Bob.
Amen.
He sure don't look like Uncle Mike.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. The scripture tells us that God is a spirit. And a spirit has not flesh nor bone.
Go
so
ahead.
Throw the black out. Throw the white
go
out.
Ahead.
Throw the Hebrew look
go
out.
Ahead.
God don't look like that.
Go ahead.
1 Timothy, amen, back to chapter 6, verse 17.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible said that Christ was the image of the invisible.
Amen.
Can't see him. So I can't tell you what it looks like, but we're going to look at the word just a little bit more. 1 Timothy 6 and 17.
Charge them that are rich in this world.
Charge them that are rich in this world.
That they be not high-minded, nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy.
1 Timothy 6 and 17. What you just read, I'm sorry. Apologize. 16.
Who only hath immortality, dwelling in the light which no man can approach unto, whom no man hath seen, nor can see.
No man can see him.
To whom be honor and power everlasting.
No
Amen.
Man can see him, nor have anybody seen him.
Amen.
So throw all ideas of what he looked like out of your mind. Deuteronomy chapter 4. Amen. Praise God. Even though the Lord did ascend down on Mount Sinai. Amen. Praise God. And the scripture said that the nobles saw beneath his feet this glorified, amen, praise God, vision. Amen. Praise God. And Even though they saw all of these things, Abraham, amen, he appeared unto Abraham. Amen, praise God. Out of all that is seen, amen, praise God, throughout their journeys. Amen. Deuteronomy 4 and verse 15 tells us this.
Take ye therefore good heed unto yourself, for ye saw no matter of similitude on the day that the Lord spake unto you in Horeb out of the midst of the fire.
They saw no particular image.
Amen.
None, no particular facial features.
Amen.
None that they could sit down and draw out. None that they could sculpt out. Amen. There was nothing, amen, that God revealed about his physical face, amen, in which anyone, praise God, can make an image of. Continue reading there, brother.
Lest ye corrupt yourselves and make you a graven image, the similitude of any figure, that likeness of male or female, the likeness of any beast that is on the earth, the likeness of any winged fowl that flies in the air.
So he warned them not to make any type of image of anything on this, on what they of this earth, anything that reflects anything on this earth, because they did not see that on Mount Sinai. Lord. So if they didn't see God, amen, praise God, and they saw him descend down on Mount Sinai, Abraham saw him, amen, praise God, in the figure, amen, praise God, of a man, but he did not see God's face. Moses, amen, a meek and humble man of all those that dwell upon the earth, only thing he saw was his backside. Amen. The nobles, amen, praise God, saw something beneath his feet. Habakkuk saw as horns coming out of his hand. But nowhere on record do we have anybody declaring that they saw his face. Amen. God has declared that he is so holy that there's not a single man on the planet earth that is able to see his face.
But
John 5 and 37 tells me that there was a man who saw what you and I would love to see. Amen, praise God. And through the gospel of the kingdom, one day we will see. 5 and 37.
And the Father himself which has sent me.
The Father himself which has sent me.
Have borne witness of me.
Have borne witness of me.
Ye have neither heard his voice at any time.
Ye have neither heard his voice at any time.
Nor seen his shape.
Nor seen his shape. Only Christ.
Only
he is the only one that have seen his face. No other man has gotten that opportunity.
Amen.
Paul, Apostle Paul, have ascended to the third heavens. Amen. Praise God. But he did not see, amen, his face. He saw things that he could not utter, amen, or speak. But one thing he did not see was the face of God.
Amen.
But one day, hallelujah, Paul couldn't see him at that moment. But according to the gospel of the kingdom, amen, praise God, that there's going to be a time on this earth.
Go ahead.
Amen, praise God, for a period of about 1,000 years.
Go ahead.
In fact, exactly 1,000 years.
Go ahead.
In which God, Christ, his son, will reign as King of kings and Lord of lords. Amen. He is going to set, amen, all everything straight.
Go ahead.
Amen, praise God, that has been out of place, put out of place, amen. Amen, praise God, because of the wickedness of man. Glory be to 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Amen, praise God. Let's listen to what the word of the Lord says. Verse 24.
Then cometh the end, when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father. When he shall have put down all rule and all authority and
power. Then cometh the end. When Christ have ruled on this earth for 1,000 years. Amen, praise God. And then there's going to be another period of 100 years. Amen, praise God. In which all those that have never got an opportunity to hear the truth of God, amen, will receive the opportunity. And after that, listen to what the scripture says. Then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to God, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power. When Christ has conquered, amen, all of the kingdoms of this earth and become his, and all order has been restored, then there's going to be a time frame in which it is called the end.
Amen.
The end. Revelation chapter 21. Amen. Praise God. Verse 3. There's got to be an end. Amen. And it's at the end in which you and I going to see something, amen, that the little children have been asking about all their lives. You've been inquiring about it. Amen. You may have been wondering about it. What do the God, amen, praise God, of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob look like? Amen. I can't see his face now in the natural state that I'm in. Amen. Praise God. And God might give me a vision that allows me to go to the third heaven, but I still won't see his face. But there's going to come a day. There's going to come an end in which I will and you will by the power of God. Give me Revelation chapter 21. Amen. Verse 3.
And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying. Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men.
The tabernacle of God is with men.
And he will dwell with them.
He shall dwell with them.
And they shall be his people.
And they shall be his people.
And God himself shall be with them.
And who will be with them?
And God himself shall be with them.
Who will be with them?
And God himself.
Amen. Praise God. So God is going to be with the saints. God is going to be with the redeemed. God is going to be with those that have his spirit. And when God comes down, my God, when God dwells among his people, the mystery of what it looks like, the mystery of his appearance will be over. Revelation chapter 22, verse 3. Amen. Praise God. Right now, you can imagine all you want to. Amen. You can come up with all kind of ideas, but there only will be an idea. Amen. But one day, Revelation chapter 22, amen, verse 3.
And there shall be no more curse.
There shall be no more curse.
But the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it.
But the throne of God and of the Lamb
shall be in it.
Shall be in
and
it.
His servant shall serve
him. And his servant shall serve him.
And they shall see his face.
And they shall what?
See his face.
They shall what?
See his face.
His servants will see his face.
And his name shall be in their forehead.
And his name shall be in their forehead. I don't know what it looks like right now. But my faith, one day, I will see him. Right now, I see him through a glass darkly. But on this day, I will see Christ face to face. But at the end, when the temple of God is amongst the people of God, we shall see his face. Until then, no man knows what God looks like. God bless you.
Amen.